The GA4 user interface can be a bit of a shock when you're coming from UA. There's less data shown, less reports, which can make people think that there's less information available, but it is there, you just need to do some digging to find it. In this video, I'll cover some of the most common reports you were probably using in UA, and now how to find that information in GA4. Of course, there are lots of third-party reporting tools out there, but if you want to use GA4 and not learn a new tool, this video is for you. Before we get into the individual reports, I want to cover a couple of new features in GA4 that are really useful. First off is report editing. In UA, as you see here, you did have this edit icon, and if you click that, then it would take you off to custom reports and you would create a custom version of the report you saw in front of you. In GA4, it's a little bit different. Flipping over to GA4, you can see I have a pencil icon here, but what it actually lets you do is change the report that's in front of you. For example, I can remove, in this case, this is an overview report. I can add or remove cards. If I go back and then let's switch into a detail report, and then we're going to click the pencil icon, then you can see we can actually change the dimensions and metrics that are shown on this page. For example, if this isn't an e-commerce site and we want to remove revenue, we could click X on revenue and then apply, and then that will no longer be listed in this report. Now it's gone. You can really customize the metrics that make sense for you, and it changes it for everybody. So if you want to save changes to current report, it would change the default report that you see in front of you, or you can save it as a new report as well. And then it will be reflected on all reports from here on out. If you did have custom reports in UA, you can do custom reports in GA4 as well. That's done here under the library section at the bottom left. In the library, you can create different collections of reports that you can make accessible in GA4. What's nice about collections is you can group things together, and you can even set a custom report or any report to be the first thing you see when you open up GA4. You can do that by clicking the three little dots next to any one of these overview type reports, and then you can click Set as Report Snapshot. One last thing before we get into the reports. When you're looking at a report, there are three really useful features. If we scroll down a bit, you'll see there's this drop down here where you can change how the report is presented. That's why it looks like there's less reports in GA4, because in UA there was a separate report for things in this drop down. Secondly, you can click this plus symbol here to open up a second dimension. For example, if we wanted to see session default by city, we could add that as a secondary dimension. And third, you can use a search field here, which feels really hidden, to filter the data that you're looking at. Now, let's figure out where to find our favorite UA reports in GA4. The first report we're going to take a look at is the channels report, which is found under Acquisition All Traffic Channels in UA. This is a really common report that myself and a lot of other people used quite often. Now, traffic is grouped here under these default channel groupings based on rules that are baked into UA. And the same is true for GA4, although there are some changes to channels and some new channels that we covered in our video on the differences between UA and GA4. To find this in GA4, you would go to Acquisition, and then you can go to either User or Traffic Acquisition. User acquisition shows the first way that people got to your website, and traffic acquisition is more focused on individual sessions. That being said, remember we discussed in the differences video, the users only really matter as a metric if you have user logins. Otherwise, you can't guarantee that you're truly tracking users across multiple sessions. So let's open traffic acquisition. By default, this information will be shown to you in the session default channel group, just like UA. And of course, you can change that using the drop down here if, let's say, you wanted to view it by source medium instead. The next report we'll look at is for events. And in UA, that's under behavior, events, and then we're looking at the top events part. We use this report quite a lot to make sure that events were recording as they should, and since everything is an event in GA4, it's even more important here. In GA4, you can see this information under Engagement and then Events. You can click on any one of the individual events to show more information. For example, you can click on the page view, and then you can scroll down to see additional information as well. Another really useful report in UA was landing pages. And if you work in SEO, I'm sure you use that quite a lot to see which landing pages were getting the most organic traffic. That in UA was found under behavior, site content, and landing pages. There actually wasn't a landing pages report in GA4 for quite a while, but there is now, and that's found under engagement and then landing page. Now, what if you want to filter this for just organic traffic? You'll click on this chart icon at the top right, which opens up comparisons. And then what you're going to do is add a new comparison. This is like segments in UA. For the dimension, we're going to start typing in channel. Then we're going to say session default channel group, and we just want organic search. We're going to click OK, and then we're going to click apply. Now you can see that the report is showing both segments, all users and organic users. If you just want to see organic users, you would click the three little dots here and click Remove Comparison, or up here across the top, you can click the X icon here to remove all users. And then we're going to click this X here to close the comparisons panel. Now, don't forget that if this is a report you use a lot, instead of having to make a comparison every single time, you could click the pencil icon to customize the report, add the filter in, and click Save. I would recommend doing this and saving it as a new report so that someone else doesn't come in later to try to find non-organic traffic and can't. Next, let's look at what devices people are using when browsing your site. In UA, this report was towards the bottom of the audience section, and it was under mobile and then devices, even though it was able to show different types of devices, not just mobile devices. In GA4, you're going to go to User, Tech, and then Tech Details. And then in the dropdown, you're going to choose device category. This is shown by browser by default. If we choose device category, then we can see the breakdown of desktop, mobile, and tablet. Again, if this is a report you use a lot, you can make a custom copy and add it to a collection to add it to your report list. To end this off, let's look at conversions. Of course, conversion metrics are included in most reports, but what if you want to look a bit deeper? Most of the time, people would use the goal overview report quite a bit, which is under conversions, goals, and overview. And if you were digging a little bit deeper, you might go into multi-channel funnels and the overview as well. Now, we're going to take a look in GA4, and all these reports are under the advertising section, which is a little weird because I guess they're assuming everyone is running Google Ads, which I'm sure Google would love, but not everyone is. Even if you aren't running Google Ads, this is where your conversions are going to be. There's two reports in here under attribution. One is model comparison, the other is conversion paths. The model comparison report works quite a lot like the UA report did, where you can select two different models. In this case, it's showing us by default the cross-channel last click model and the cross-channel data-driven model. We can change it and say, what if I change it to first click instead? And it would show us the change in conversions and revenue, really similar to how this worked in UA. Then under conversion paths, you can see where the touch points are based on the model you've selected. We're using the default channel group using the cross-channel data-driven model. One thing that I find really weird about this report is that these sections are exactly the same size, regardless of the percentage that's early, mid, or late. Of course, the bars are bigger, but really, I think that these sections here should be bigger. If the early touch points are only 9.5% of the traffic and late touch points is 76% of the traffic, why isn't the late touch points column 76% of the width of this particular report? Really keep that in mind when you're taking a look at these reports. You might need to look at percentages to see how much is actually early, mid, and late, instead of just visually thinking that it's all equal, because it probably isn't. This overview should get you started on using reports in GA4, and now you should feel comfortable finding similar reports or even making your own reports based on what you looked at the most in UA. Do you still have more questions? Check out our other videos to get more answers and leave a comment letting us know what topics you want us to cover in future videos. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe.